Salvete, Discipuli. Welcome back to Agora Academy. Recently, we've been doing a lot of talking about nouns. We learned all about the second declension. And we even snuck in a couple of lessons about the ablative of place from which and the accusative of place to which. Today, we're going to switch our focus to verbs. In this lesson, we're just going to go over a few terms and learn a little lingo that will help you as you learn the imperfect and future tenses in the next couple of lessons. First term up, mood. When we're talking about grammar, the word mood doesn't refer to whether you're feeling happy or sad. The word mood, when we're talking about verbs, refers to the type or category of verb form. There are different moods for expressing things like facts, direct commands, and wishes. Right now, all you have to worry about is one single mood. It's called the indicative. The indicative is just a fancy-sounding term that's really pretty simple. The indicative mood is used for declarative sentences and the expression of facts. Most of the time you're talking, you are using the indicative mood. The indicative mood is pretty much just regular speech. Okay, great. In Latin, there are six tenses in the indicative. They are split into two systems based on the type of stem they use. There are three tenses in each system. In the upcoming few lessons, we are going to be looking at the tenses of the present system. Now, you've already learned the present tense. You formed the present tense by first finding your present stem, second PP, drop the RE, and then adding the present tense endings, which are OST, mustisenti. Of course, OST, mustisenti. But you remember all of that. The present system, as opposed to the present tense, refers to the group of three tenses that use the present stem that you found by going to the second principal part and chopping off the RE. The three tenses included are the present, the imperfect, and the future. At this point, we've said the word present so many times that it barely seems to mean anything anymore. Let's review the terms one more time. We are working within the indicative mood of the verb, which refers to direct speech. There are six tenses of the indicative. Three of these tenses, the present, imperfect, and future, are all united by the fact that they use the same stem. That is the present stem, which is found by going to the second principal part and chopping off the RE. Together, the present, imperfect, and future tenses form the present system. All right, scholars, that's all for today. Bonum fortunam with the comprehension exercises following the video, and we'll dive into the imperfect tense in the next lesson.